Alrighty guys, so this is the final day of this dog piece. We're not gonna work on the whole thing. We're just gonna work on part of him, mostly the face. Everything else would just be extra at the end. But I'm gonna try to do as much rendering as I can here. And we could just assume that that's what we need to do to the body. Just a little more work than what I'm actually doing, okay? So my palette is an old palette that I just found there. Again, everybody who works with me knows that I like to work with a limited palette. So here I have titanium white, lemon yellow, yellow ochre, which is more important than the lemon, cadmium red, ivory black, burnt sienna, magenta, and cerulean blue down here. Okay, it's pretty much in that order that I gave it, all right? I'm mostly going to stick to this palette though, very neutral, but I might need to, this palette over here, very neutral. But I will brighten up some of the things with these other colors over here. But that's gonna be a minority of work, okay? All right, so let's go for it, all right? So what we're gonna start working on right now is I'm gonna start working on the bright colors or the high chroma colors. Those are kind of in two families. They could be in families of something that looks really bright, or it could also be in the family of something that looks really dark, okay? What we don't wanna use right now is too much white. All right, so that said, let's get going. Oh, and just really quickly over here. Here I have a mixture of like half linseed oil, half, it's actually more terpenoid than linseed oil. You could use other things like walnut oil if you want to go thinner, or if you want to go thicker, but it takes a longer time to dry, you could use other things like Galka gel, which I'm going to use later today, okay? So here we go. And I have a range of large to medium sized brushes, kind of like here. And that's all we need, okay? Anything else is just extra material, but that should be enough, all right? So, like I said, I'm gonna start with my more brighter colors. So I'm making just myself a pretty deep black, but it's not my blackest black, by the way. If I use a really black, then I don't have, it should be a small thing that's really black. So I wanna make sure that I don't overuse my black. So this is close to black, but just don't forget it's not black. It's really important that I repeat it so many times because we don't want it to be the darkest color. All right, so I'm just gonna come in here, block, break. And the nice thing here of the mineral spirit, it actually allows my mineral spirit / linseed oil, it allows my paint to move very easily, which it wouldn't do just with pure paint. So try to make sure that you guys make your mediums, okay? So I'm being very loose. I'm making his eye a little bigger. My first pup had the eye a little too small, so it looked more like an adult. The bigger the eye, the younger the puppy. The smaller the eye, the older the puppy. All right. Any corrections that you guys want to make? Now is a good time for corrections. All right, here we go. All right, so before I go into many of my brown colors, I'm actually gonna try to go into my brighter colors. My daughter's in the studio, so you guys are gonna have to bear with the noise. All right. So remember, before I go too gray, I'm gonna try to go a little brighter. And I'm using mineral spirit again. The mixture, let's call it a mixture. We wanna make sure that whatever we're mixing, our colors are really nice and movable. And they're not gonna be very movable if I haven't used any mineral spirit. So. All right, that's pretty much the reddest of the brown, or the more red of the brown. Reddest does not exist, but more red does exist. So now I'm gonna go, right before I go into my yellow colors, I'm gonna go into my brighter orangey yellow colors, like the ones I have here. And one of the few things that I'm doing to keep my colors very neutral, I don't know if you guys noticed that these colors are not super, super, super red, is I'm not cleaning my brush. That's it, okay? If I clean my brush, I have to start mixing mud into it every time. So we could prevent that just by not cleaning the brush that we're using, okay? All right. In a quick second, I'm gonna start going really, really heavy with my yellows, okay? I think now it's a good time. And I'm adding a little yellow and white, so if you guys look at my palette, that's it right here. See my darks, my reds, my reddish tans, and my more yellow color. It's really rare when you guys only have to paint from the same color from dark to light. You probably have to look for a color as you guys change the color. In this case, the darker values are more red and the lighter values are more yellow, okay? And there's also a lot of grays involved in here. All right. And there's the other baby right there. And then once I do these bright colors, I'll start looking for my gray colors in a second. So this dog has everything. Okay, so right now I'm just doing the blocking in of my more yellow colors. And don't forget, these colors are perfectly fine for you guys to overdo, okay? If you guys don't overdo these colors, later on the dog's gonna be way too flat if all the colors look very light. So if you have a problem, have this problem. Make sure your colors are a little more contrast rather than too much contrast together, okay? Some darks here. All right. And I think that I'm quite illustrative. So, I think I'm pretty glad with the way he's looking before I start going into my lighter grays. So I'm gonna start basically going into that, my lighter grays, okay? that. I'm gonna start doing some of my grays here. And the more grays that I use, the more brights these colors are gonna look, okay? So don't forget that color is relative. If you don't have darks, then this is your darkest, and that's gonna be pretty much it. But if you guys do have darks, then your colors are gonna be relative to that dark. One quick second, guys. So I'm still blocking in big color here. So I'm just doing all these neutral colors, okay? That's all we're working on. Just neutrals now, because we already finished the brights. So there is always color though. So some of my grays have a little bit more of a blue to it. Some of my grays have a little bit more of a green to it. So you guys could take a look at the picture and kind of decide which kind of gray I'm using, if either a more bluish gray or a more greenish gray. But that's something of observation, okay? And your eye is really critical, actually. Your eye could tell very well when something should be more green as opposed to more blue. You know, your eye could tell that. Sometimes we get lazy and we don't want to do that, but that's a little different, okay? All right. Alright, you guys, I think I'm pretty good with the grays that I'm using right now. I think I roughly have what I need. So now I'm going to start using my light yellows, okay? That's the actual color of the puppy itself. That's what we call his local color. So all these are atmospheric colors, but something is the color of the puppy, okay? And that's what I'm about to start doing on these, all these grays that we just worked on. Okay, so he's good. I would actually start using these grays over here too. I'll use them a little here before I move on, because I did say I was gonna work kind of on this area, and the whole dog is the same, okay? Other little guy. He's feisty right now. So I'm gonna start doing a much lighter, but also a little bit more of a green hue to it. The only thing I'm doing right now is I'm blocking. I'm not working with the illusion of hair right now. And I don't have to, by the way. If I block color in very well, I could do a good job without necessarily making it look like hair. But, you know, maybe if we're gonna work a little bit more realistic, hair is a good choice, and also just the practice of hair. How in the world do we make hair? You know, that practice? Actually pretty interesting to do it. Right, so let's say this is the limit. Okay, this is gonna be like the border of where I'm actually gonna be working my dog, and the rest, like I said, you guys, it's the same work. Tampoco se vale alzarlo.
¿El qué?
Alzarlo. All right, so there we go. Just finished blocking off most of my grays, adding the color that I see. I think I could still use more blue on here. So, looks pretty good. He has all the grays that I need. It's weird, I'm trying to look at both, and when I see the screen that I'm working from, it looks more green. When I see this screen, it looks super green, the one on the tablet. So I don't know which one is more correct at this point. So I'm just gonna warm it up a little bit, because that's how I see it on the actual tablet screen. But in reality, I mean, I see it more blue, but I don't know why, for some reason, on the tablet over there, it looks a little bit more, it just looks a little bit more green. Over here, it looks more brown, and then over there, it looks more green. So, I don't know what's going on. I think it's a tablet thing, the way it's registering color. I'll take a photo at the end, though, because the photo is, I think it's gonna be much more representative of the piece itself. Okay. side, so just a little cooler color. And let's start doing some of that yellow. That's the little guy I've been waiting for, because that yellow is actually him. So like I said before, I'm going to use a little bit more of a heavier chroma or a high chroma. So just a little bit more color. I know you guys might see it right now. It's like, shouldn't he go more gray? Yes, he can. But I don't want to start with such a gray color. I want to start with a little bit more of a heavier pigmentation. So what I'm doing right now is I'm mixing my light palette. So I'm not even painting. And just trying to do a range of light values. So that's why you guys don't see me applying any color. I'm just mixing and mixing and mixing and mixing and mixing and mixing. And I think I'm done mixing. And I think I'm ready to start applying. And my color has, again, a lot of oil, a lot of mineral spirits. I want it to move. I don't need stiff color. And I'm really happy with something. If you guys look at my range of color, it actually blends without me having to blend the color together. So that means that my value range is really close. It's where I want it to be. If these colors don't blend naturally, it means that I have a lot of contrast. They will blend because they're in the same family. They're all yellows and oranges. But if they don't seem like they're blending, then it means that I have too much contrast between the colors. So, a little more characteristics. And I probably use some of my underpainting too. I actually like the red of my underpainting without having to add anything new. Actually, I'm happy with that too. Everyone's hungry. So here he goes. Oh, he's hungry. And as I start introducing this new yellow, the reds should start perceiving more red. I'm not just introducing a lighter color, but I'm also introducing a more yellow color. So, I'm going to start blocking in. The rest of the colors that we see here. So once we finish blocking in all the big colors, that's when we are gonna start doing textures, okay? So pretty much doing everything that feels like a dog's hair, or, you know, at least a texture. And we could start moving into the grays pretty soon. And finally into the whites. And again, a lot of mineral spirit. Let this thing flow. I'm going to start pushing in some of the lights from in here into that kind of bearded mustache area here, just to have some of the lights and the darks close to each other. All right, and let's start looking for those cold lights. I'm gonna clean my brush for my highlights. If I don't clean my brush, it'll never be a highlight, it'll always be a mid-tone, okay? Because there's gonna be some mud into it, and even though we do prefer mud for the big majority of the painting, we do not prefer mud for the highlight, okay? I'm also gonna start using my gels pretty soon, this guy here. Start adding some textures onto my picture. Not yet though, but pretty soon. And again, that reason when I'm not doing anything, I'm just mixing a range of colors. And I'm letting some of those siennas come through. It'll brighten up the pup just ever so subtle. Forgot some browns in that area, so I'll go ahead and I'll apply it. All right. And I'm also seeing what's missing. The more color that I apply, I could see that I'm missing some deeper reds. I see that I'm missing some more yellow colors. But this is the time to do them. You know, whenever you notice them, just go ahead and start pushing them in as well. All right, more darks here. There we go. More darks here. There's also more yellow missing because he does have this golden kind of feel to him, which he doesn't quite have on my picture yet. All right, but that's why we work, to make sure we figure out what's on the picture and what's not. Now he does have that golden color, which is good. So, just a little bit more color, a little bit more hue saturation. So he pretty much has all the reds now. I don't see him having anything missing in terms of color. What I do see him missing is lights. I do see something missing in terms of value. Okay. And we'll try to tackle that in a second. I'm just going to go ahead and introduce some of these deeper grays. And let us use that smaller brushes here. And let's start blocking in the really nice lights. This color is extremely light. Overall, he's already blocked in. He's already becoming what he needs to be turning into. And just no texture, though. At this point, he's still a very soft dog. He's just blocks in of color. But the texture, we could start pretty much giving it as we do lighter colors. So let's say I go into my smaller brushes, okay? Brushes like these. I'm going to start moving my lights into it, and everything has lights, okay? These have lights, these have lights, these have lights. But now as I do that, I'm also gonna be a little bit more careful on how I'm moving that, okay? And let me do a little quick change. I see that his nose is too, his kind of like a consequential thing. His nose is too thin or too flat, which in kind of in a way makes the snout too small too. But this is the good thing about painting. You could you know, figure out things as we're going along. So this was too narrow, which made the snout too narrow. But now that I lowered the nose, I should be able to lower the snout at this point. It makes him look cuter too, because he has that. All right, now I have more space to push down these lights that I had not pushed before, because it perceived right before, but it just perceived right because the snout was smaller, but then this part looked wrong, so at this point, I'm able to maneuver the color down and just start moving these guys around. All right. So there we go. I like the snout that's a little bigger now. And let's start doing some of the yellows. That's where I left off before I got sidetracked because of that black. And texture's good. Little guy's looking good. And detail, okay? These guys might look a little out of place, but that's just because they are the brightest highlight. I just blocked the color in. Now, I have to work the color out. Then we do all the color variations that we can find. If you guys see little blues or little greens, make sure you throw little blues or little greens. Again, I'm doing a lot of grays now, because remember the first colors had a lot of brights, so we have to find a way to balance that out. And I think it's doing pretty good. All right, now I'm going to start using my gels, and that's where I want to start working with that furry looking, you know, the brush strokes that kind of blend together, but they blend together in terms of fur, not just moving big brushes around. Okay, so the whole picture is wet. Okay, we got to understand that the gel is going to move all the colors around. But the trick here is to try to move your brush just with the contours of the hair. So let's say, for example, I'm working on this area, okay? I wanna make sure that my contours move in that direction. Here, I wanna make sure that they move in this direction. And it also gives texture. The gel gives texture to your brush strokes. All right. Right. And if some things are off, you could still come back and readjust some color. Like if I need to push some more blacks in here, I could do that with some gel. And don't forget that part of painting is also letting your pictures breathe. So when you're done with something, you don't have to be done with that something. It's good to step away and come back to your piece later. Once you start a painting, it's not meant to be there forever, you know, meant to be worked on forever and ever without ever stopping. You could take breaks. Also, if you're not hitting any good notes, like everything feels wrong, you could stop and regroup and come back a different day. And I guess that's correct for everything in life. You don't always just have to work it one time. If things are not working out, you could always just take a small break and try to recover things after. And the gel, that's part of the tricks that old artists use or experienced artists use to make things look better. Okay? It's not necessary, but it does make a big difference. All right. So little guy's looking pretty good. You know, I'm liking him. I'm leaving a lot more brush strokes than what many people are looking for. But again, that's because that's the way I like to paint. If you guys want to do a lot more brush strokes to show more fur, you guys could definitely do that. If you guys want that expression of the dog and you guys don't want to get rid of a lot of the brush strokes, then you guys don't have to do that, okay? This is more of a taste or before the doc looked more refined, but to me just looked too soft, too kind of, I had heart, but almost like, to me just looked too much like paint by number almost. So the gel gave it just that little bit of life, a little bit of presence, and a more painterly feel to it. And there's a lot of texture to this little guy now. And I'm not scared, but I'm pensive and always aware that I don't want to overwork something. So sometimes if I had enough work and it's like, oh man, I work too much, you know, I don't want to come back and fix that, because then that even works even more. See some grace over here. I might not be too happy with the contrast in here. So I might just find a few tones there. And that looks okay with me. Now I'm going to start doing some of the grayish blues. And this color has a lot of blue. On. Right. All right, just trying to finish up this little guy's details. So I'm going to use a heavy gel and a heavy black. not everywhere. Mostly next to my lights. And the dog doesn't have this on the picture. You guys could play around with this, but you could always give him that little twinkle of life on the eye. Again, he doesn't have it, so it's not like a requirement, but it would definitely make him look a little livelier. Okay. So if like somewhere over here, just came in with a little bit of blue. And just give the dog the tiny, 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 tiny bit of life that he might be asking for. All right, well, that's pretty much it. I mean, you guys could block in the background. Any color, actually like that surreal yellow, like mustardy yellow. I might just do something along those lines. And super, super saturated. I could do the chair too, but I just like that really oversaturated color. Use a bigger brush too. And there's the little guy, okay? At least from where we left the last time. And remember, you guys could do more work over here in the bottom. I mean, the only concern that I have on mine is he feels a little too flat. So I might just come in and do some more reds. But aside from that, I think I'm okay with him. So need some darks too, because the color needs to be deep. There we go. All right. And it's much better. Okay, it's a little bit more red. All right. Maybe his forehead's a little too low. Now it's a good time to extend. All right. And now let's call it quits. All right, you guys, we'll have fun. This project took me just about an hour and a half, like 2 hours, somewhere in there. Make sure that you guys have fun, okay? And there's no need to rush. The only reason why I'm not rushing, but I'm not going too slow, is that this is a study, and it's a really fun study for me. But it's more to me just a study about the textures and also an understanding that you guys should have when you guys are working from home. Okay, so have fun with this little guy, and also work on the body, work on the feet and all that stuff. We should be all set, okay? Have a great weekend. Bye-bye.